Hi, I'm Mark Lassoff from Framework. Over the last decade, I've taught coding to almost 2 million people online, in live courses, and in the corporate classroom. As we get started, just a reminder to hit the like button and subscribe so you won't miss any of the free training that I put on YouTube. Once you've learned the fundamentals of development, it's time to start working on projects. Projects are an important part of the learning process for several reasons. First, they help you integrate and synthesize the skills you've learned. Often, new coding and development techniques are taught in isolation, and it's by completing projects that you'll start to understand how the techniques relate to each other. Projects also help you learn a development process. That process takes you from the beginning of a project through to the end. I find that many new developers know how to complete the various components of an individual project, but are not completely sure how to manage a full app development project. You'll learn this from completing projects to put in your portfolio. Perhaps the best reason to start creating projects is to create a portfolio of work that shows what you're capable of. I like to see portfolios that show a progression of learning from code labs to complete projects. If you're not traditionally trained in software development, your portfolio is particularly important, as it's the only convenient way for potential employers to assess your development skills. If you're going to freelance, your portfolio will be a source of validation for companies that might consider hiring you. You're actually going to need to develop two portfolios with your project work. Technical employers are going to want to see a GitHub portfolio. Your code repository should be up to date, well documented, and have correct code checked in. You'll also want to show frequent and recent updates so that your recruiter knows that you're active and continuing to develop new skills. Many jobs are with non-technical employers. You might be interviewing to be a web developer for a small manufacturing company or retail catalog. At this type of employer, it's likely that you'll be interviewed by someone who's non-technical. They won't know what to do with a GitHub repository or what they're looking at. This type of recruiter needs a portfolio website. I've listed a link to a blog article I wrote below, where you can see some excellent examples of developer portfolios. Now, let's talk about the projects you should put inside your portfolio. I'm going to separate these into three categories that you can work through at different points in your training. The first projects can be completed with just HTML and CSS. The next category are client-side development projects that require HTML, CSS, and the JavaScript programming language. The final category requires server-side development skills. So you'll need to also have a server-side language at your disposal, like PHP or Node.js. So here we go. First category, HTML and CSS projects. The first project is a responsive form page. Take a web application that requires a long form, for example, a medical admission form or a registration form. Lay the form out using HTML and CSS. Be sure to modify the form so that the form fields are attractive and usable and don't look like just standard HTML forms. Make sure the form has a logical tab order so you can move from one field to the other with the tab key. Finally, make sure the form is responsive so it looks good on big screens, tablets, and phone-sized devices. The next project I'd recommend is a restaurant website. Pick a local restaurant that has an ugly website and using your HTML and CSS skills, redesign the site. Be sure to include the entire menu, photos, operating hours, and a contact form. Visual design counts here as people don't want to buy from businesses with ugly websites. Here's a bonus tip. Offer the site to a restaurant for free when you're done. If they decide to replace their old site with your work, you're now a professional web developer with live work on the web to show off. Another HTML and CSS project I'd recommend is a photography site. Knowing how to display photography in a pleasing way is an important skill. Look at some other photography sites on the web, and you can display your own photos in your site or use free stock photography available on sites like pexels.com. Don't forget to create a cool navigational scheme that allows the user to easily move from one photo to another. One more HTML and CSS project I recommend is a high-converting sales page. Anyone who does e-commerce work thinks in terms of sales. Creating a sleek sales page that will get customers from the shopping cart to the finalized sale is something that most recruiters can appreciate. Your web portfolio itself is a project. The goal here is to present your work in a positive light, describe what you did, and impress the viewer with your web development skills. It should have links and images from other projects you've worked on. I recommend starting this one first so you have a place to display all the project work you'll be doing. Okay, now let's switch over to category two, client-side development projects that require HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. The first project I'd recommend here is a to-do list application. This is a simple CRUD app. CRUD is an acronym for Create, Retrieve, Update, and Delete. CRUD refers to the individual records in an application. So for the to-do list application, you want for users to enter items into the list, modify them, and check them off when complete. You'll use the browser's local storage object or an appropriate library like local forage to store the data. You might consider using a CSS framework so your app is responsive and looks good. The next app I'd recommend is a client-side API-based application. In these apps, you're consuming an outside API and doing something useful with it. There are a number of APIs out there that you can use. For example, you might use the Chicago Transit Authority API to build something around the Chicago bus or train system, what Chicagoans call the L. Another option is to build a game. There are a number of excellent game libraries out there like Phaser.js that use JavaScript. With JavaScript and Phaser, you can build an arcade-style video game that's fun to play and to build. Games generally require a complex level of coding and can be a great vehicle to show off your development skills. If you build a game, make sure to include good visuals, sounds, and make it actually fun to play. Think about simulating carnival games like whack-a-mole or balloon darts. The last project I'd put in this category is a geolocation application. For example, you can build an app that locates close by restaurants and puts them on a map. You can create click-throughs on the map that provide additional information from a geolocation API. You're going to want to look into Google Maps API for this. Google Maps is pretty much a standard, and while there are other strong mapping packages, no recruiter is going to question using the gold standard. Our last category is full-stack projects that require the use of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, as well as server-side skills like PHP and the MySQL database. These full-stack apps usually make use of a middle layer to interact with the database on the server. My favorite full-stack app to build for your portfolio is a quiz show-style app. Create a way to store questions and answers in a server-side database. Then when the game is played, use the database questions to quiz the user and score their answers. Don't forget to create an administrative panel through which the administrator can create new questions and answers and manage questions that are already in the database. Another full-stack project that should be in your portfolio is a catalog application. While this is a very traditional CRUD application, it fully shows off your ability to create a server-side database and then build an application around it. You can even build a client-side shopping cart to show how you can efficiently marry the client-side and server-side in a project. So there you go. I think there are enough project suggestions there to fill your portfolio and keep you busy for quite a while. In the description below, I put a few links to project videos I have on YouTube to give you a guide to producing some of the projects I've discussed here. I'm Mark Lassoff from Framework. Don't forget to like this video so you see more of our training content. You can also visit our website at frameworktv.com to get access to even more content to help you become a professional level developer. Have fun building. I'll see you soon.